Okay, this is Jeff live from familygokarts.com. What we're going to do here today is we're going to show you how to set up a 250 Rhino Taotao ATV. It's a four-speed manual with reverse. So first thing, we'll get it out of the box here. Just cut these off. Okay, next step, what we're going to do is we're going to take the metal. Generally, these are 14s, so you can use a socket. And then the inside are generally 13s, not all the time, and so forth. So what we're going to do is we're going to take these top bolts off so we can lift this completely off. And so okay, we took the 8 bolts on the bottom. And what we're going to do is we're going, then you got to remove this one. You keep this bolt, do not throw this one away. And sometimes if you notice, the metal will rub into the cables. There is nothing wrong with those cables at all. It will happen. These are ATVs, they're hardy ATVs, but sometimes that does happen. Of course, we don't want it to happen, but is that anything that will inoperate your ATV? The answer is no. So I'm going to set this over here, just set it over there. And then what we're going to do is take this off. Okay, next step, pretty obvious, is to take out the plastic on these. So we'll get the plastic off. Where I take the tires off. The tires do not come with air, so you got to put the air in on them. So you're going to take the tires off. Be gentle so nothing breaks. So we're going to set the tires over here. How you can tell if you come up real close, your back tires has a spindle in them. You got your air valve obviously goes outside, and then that's your front tire. We have back here our other tires. So we come back here, we look right here. If you come back here, let's untie this here. So we're just getting everything out right now. Okay, this piece here is used to put on the rear tail light. So we're going to get that removed. Everything looks good. When you remove that, just look at the brake line. We've never had it happen, but of course something could wear through the brake line. Just look at it, make sure all is well. So we have pieces under here. Looks like we're tied down. Okay, now there on the front here we have 2 bolts, one on each side, one on the other side. So this is not one long bolt with a nut, just to let you know, and we're just going to take them out. Okay, what we did to remove this from the crate, because Kurt and I did it, and there's only 2 of us here today, so we couldn't show you how we did it. So what I did was we loosened these bolts. Now, like I said before, we kept them, because you're going to need them, most likely. So we kept them. So I got underneath here. I lifted that up. Kurt did not grab up here. He grabbed underneath here. We lift them up, moved it to the side. And what we did, as you can see, is we took off the pallet and that bottom piece. So, and then we have what we did here, come over here, then we set this on the center, because this is the strongest part of the unit. That way we get it out of the ground so we can put on the rear tires and the front tires. Okay, what do we want to do before we put on the tires is we open up this box. This is your owner's manual. I'm just going to put these bolts over here. So this is your tool kit. We have our coverings for the tires in here. This is our battery acid. Okay, that's our top there. So I'm going to set that there. We've got a couple of wrenches in here. This is your CD. We have braces that we will need. These are most likely for the battery, I'm guessing. Mm-hmm. We have our bolts. These bolts in this bag is used to put on our side footrests. Mm-hmm. So I'll show you guys. So this is what I like to do. We'll put the battery stuff together. That's your side rest. We have another one there. We have two big lock washers that should be for the rear tires. And then we have, these are used to put on the handlebars. These are your U shape. So you're going to have four of these, and you should have four of the bolts. We did keep this extra one because unfortunately sometimes they forget to include a bolt or two. So that's why I always like to keep everything. So this gives you a good lowdown of what this is for your, I would suspect for your battery. Yep, this is for your battery. And I'll show you that stuff there. So this is what, we'll move this to the side. This is what comes in your, in that box there. And as you can see, there's one bolt for each of those brackets. This one here was laying loose in the box. So again, I like to put everything together. So this way everything's there, makes it easier to set. Okay, first of all, if you come up close here, this is going to be hard to read on there, but this is 25 PST max to seat the seat bed. So what that means is each tire you have to bring up to 24 PSI. This is why they provide you a tire gauge. And then 10 PSI operating pressure. So you bring it up to 25 and then you let off the air down to 10. One way to do that is with an air pump. That's going to take you a long time to pump all four tires, but that is possible. So what we're going to do is we have an air compressor. We're going to fill all these tires up to 24, then bring them back down to 10. And that's what we're going to do. Bring them up to 24. That seals the seat. And then you bring it down to 10. So what we're going to do is we're going to fill this up to at least 24 PSI. 24, at least 24, 25 to 30. Don't go much more than that. So now we're going to bring down to 10, and you do that by using the end there. We're good. Okay, what we're going to do first of all is we're going now install the back tires. Everything is here we need. Your cotter key, your nut. And washer. These are directional, so you want the narrow pointing that way, valve stem on the outside, and then we're going to put and remember we had those lock washers. We're going to grab those because that should go here. And the back tire, I want to get it nice and tight. Not overly tight, but get it nice and tight. We got it tight. We got to put that cotter pin back in. Bend it. And then you have, while we're doing that, we're going to put on your rubber. And the best way to do, sometimes they don't go on worth a darn. If they don't go on very good, you take a little, like WD-40, put it in there. But the best way to put these on is to twist them. Go like ring around the rosy or around the clock. That's the best way to put them on. So we're going to do the other side. These are directional tires, so that means the narrow part, the arrow part, points forward. The valve stem goes on the outside, not the inside. Line it up. Put it on.
put the big washer on first, lock washer, then the nut, tighten in with your fingers, then take wrench and tighten it in a circle. There we go. Okay, let's install the front tires. Front tires take a little bit more to install, but they're not difficult. What we have to do is we've got to take this piece so it goes 180 degrees. You cannot put the tire on like that. So what I have found that's the easiest way to do that is we're going to remove this bottom piece. We're going to remove this car pin. We're just going to straighten this so it's easier to get back in, hopefully. Okay, then what we're going to do is we're going to take this. Now what we do is take that, we're going to put it back in place like this. Because the reason we had to remove this is we were hitting that bottom piece there. So now we're going to put this back on. Okay, this came with it and that fits right on there. That works really good. So we're going to tighten that right down. What we're going to do before we put the tire on, we're going to install the tie rod. Okay, notice how that comes. You have the lock washer up behind this. Put this on like this here. That's right. The lock washer on this one here goes actually like this. The lock washer goes in first on this model. Line that up in there. Now the tie rod's installed, so what we're going to do next is we're going to put on the front tire. Again, we're going to pull off the cotter key. We have to put on the disc brakes first. So, this goes on first. Now, this knob right here, this square, this here, this goes on like this is it. When you put it in, the front tires take a little bit more to get on than the back tires because they have bearings in them. So I gotta make sure I stick my fingers in there, make sure the bearings line up. Because it's got to get over that piece there. There we go. Just turn it. Sometimes they'll rub a little bit, and that's only a little bit. If they're too tight, you can't move it, then that means the front drum brakes need to be adjusted. Now we're going to put, again, we put the lock washer on first. I mean the big washer on first, because we only have to finger tight these because we do not want to squeeze the crap out of this. Let's make sure we're all the way in. You finger tight them and just line it up to the next hole. You do not want to tighten these way too tight, because if you get them too tight, that squish kills the bearing. Yep. Okay, we had problems getting the wheel on last time, so I took it back off, and I put it back on. And sometimes you just have to do that. And now we're having no problems getting the wheel on. Sometimes these are temperamental, and so so now we're putting this in. There we go. Love the cotter pin. This is the quickest and best way to do it. We tried that other ways, but this is by far the best. And then of course, this one here, cotter pin's in the way. So let's turn that around so we can get that. We want to get the cotter pin out without ruining it too bad. Don't even have to take it completely off. Just pound on it just a little bit so we can just see what's happening. Is this piece here is hitting the bottom of the shock piece. They put it in like this so it takes up less space for shipping, thus a better price for you. So now what we're going to do is we're going to put that back on. This came in your toolkit, and the one side fits in right on that. Down a little bit. Okay. Next thing we're going to put on is and why I'm grabbing this is you don't want to go like this here. That is, we don't want the front drum cable to get underneath the tie rod. So I'm just kind of setting this over here so it goes on the top. And because we're talking from experience, it's happened to us. So now if you notice, we're removing the cotter pin. We have the nut. And then there's a lock washer. And when you put this in, the lock washer stays up here. And that fell off, but we got it. Okay, we gotta put this in. Lock washer goes here. I want to tighten it, but not too tight. Get in, bend down, bend up. Now what we're going to do is put on the drum brake. Now look at this here. This is square piece that lines up right onto there. But first of all, same situation. All right. Take out the cotter washer. We're going to put this on here first, and we make sure this is actually this is spread a little bit. If you notice, this should be parallel. I don't like that when that's like that. So what we're going to do is we're just going to adjust that real quick. I'm going to show you how to do that. We had to do it on the other side. Makes it hard. First of all, this is how a drum brake works, is when this spreads, that causes friction. Well, that's already a little bit, and that's going to make it harder to put this on. So what we're going to do is we're just going to loosen this up here. To remove it, you do have to remove this nut completely because it won't slide out. Where's that flat piece? That putty knife, straight edge. So what I did was, now look at this here. See how that is straight up and down parallel. There's no spacing. That'll make it easy. And this is not something you have to do with every unit. This is rare, actually, but I'm glad we have to do this on this one. This way I can show it on the video. That way if you run into that problem. Now, I line this up and see how that is. Now I can put the bolt right in the center there. Okay, that problem is fixed. So now we're going to slide this on. Notice how this runs this way. This is correct. This will line up right into there. The reason it does is then when you brake, it will move or shift. Again, directional tires. Arrow goes in the front. Valve stem on the outside. Sometimes these go in easy. And other times they're right there. This went in pretty easy for us. The other tire took us two times to get in. Again, we finger tight it and then just line up to the next hole. We don't need any tighter than that. You want it to spin freely. See how nice that spins? Now we're going to put the cotter key in. We're going to twist that. Grab the rubber cap. Now, sometimes you're going to need to put a little WD-40 on that. Sometimes you can without. There we go. It's best to put it on by twisting it, like going around the clock. And that's installing a front tire on a Rhino 250.